How you doing, folks? I've got a pan here. I just got done doing some cooking. A little bit of meat stuffed with some cheese, wrapped with bacon. And it's still warm, but I can hold it indefinitely. I've already ate and come back to the pan and I see this. How am I going to clean this? Well, I'm going to show you how to clean this. First of all, we're going to scrape it out. I got my wood spatula, and if you don't have any wood, get yourself some wood. They're utensils. They're cheap. They're relatively cheap. These are teak. They don't have to be teak. They could be any kind of hardwood. They're easy to take care of, and they won't ruin your seasoning. They got a nice edge on them. So what we're going to do here is we're just going to scrape it out. We'll get the big chunks out. That's all we're going to do. There's that cheese. It's stuck on a little bit. Cast iron is great for cooking. There is a learning curve. Cleanup is a little more difficult than your non-stick pans, but the health benefits of cast iron outweigh the man-made chemical process, in my honest opinion, of a non-stick pan. There are some new pans out there, a little too expensive for my taste. They seem to be decent pans, the Hexclad. They're too expensive for my taste. And they're very good pans. I know somebody has one, has a set, and they're pretty decent. Do I think that they'll last 200 years? No. But I have a feeling this pan right here will last 200 years if it's taken care of. It may even last 300 years if it's taken care of. But Hexclad, I guarantee you, 40, 50 years, that pan's going to be done, if it even lasts that long. It says lifetime, but who knows? This is cast steel. That's all it is. It's cast steel. All right, I got all this scraped up. And as you can see, it don't look too bad. If you got a piece of disposable Tupperware, or you could put down some tin foil, pour this in it, kind of wrap it up in a ball, throw it in the garbage. I'm just going to dump this in my garbage can. It's cold enough. It's not going to burn nothing. You definitely don't want this down your sink, though. Definitely don't want this down your sink. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this on about a medium. I'm going to start getting some heat in it as soon as I bacon grease and the meat juices come up to temp a little bit. I've got some crap rags that I could throw in the garbage. I go to Home Depot and go to the paint department and I get a bundle of rags and I use them when they start getting kind of worn out, then I use them for this purpose. Where I wipe down the grease and I just throw them in the garbage. You could use paper towel. I don't like paper towel on cast iron. The fibers do break down. And cleaning this teak up, I'm just going to wipe it down. You wash it with a little soap and water. You'll dry it off real good. And that's it. Every now and then, you do have to re-oil them. And when they start getting a little worn a little bit, you take a little sandpaper and you sand them down a little bit. Wash them, dry them, then you put a little oil on them. You can use any kind of oil you want. They make special oils for wood cooking utensils. I just use olive oil. Just same as cast iron, but a very tiny little drop right there. Just a tiny little drop and just a dry clean rag, and just wipe it all around and just keep on wiping it till the oil completely dries. And it's ready. And it's ready for cook for the next time. So I'll put that in the sink. and wouldn't let this come up to temp. I can already start seeing it sizzling a little bit right there. That's not too bad. Like I said, this rag is ready to go in the garbage. So it's not going to bother me to just wipe this down, throw this whole rag in the garbage. Yep, just like that. Throw this in the garbage. We're going to let this continue to come up to temp. I want to be able to get the handle kind of hot. In the bottom and the sides, definitely you want to get some heat in it. What we're going to do is we're going to turn our sink on to hot, all the way to hot, and get your water as hot as it can be. The water should be so hot that when you stick your finger through it, it's hot. You're not going to be able to put your hands under it. My hot water heater is set at like 120. If yours is set kind of cold, it's okay. Just don't bring your pan up to too high of a temp. You put warm or cold water in it, you can crack it. You can crack cast iron. But my water is 120 degrees. It's hot enough where I can't put my hands under it. It'll burn my hands. And we're going to just put a little water in here. We're going to let that sizzle. And I got another rag over here that I don't mind throwing in the garbage. There it is. I don't mind throwing this one in the garbage. It's time to buy a new bundle of rags anyways. But if you don't have rags, you can bring it up to temp. You put a little water in here. You don't want a lot of water. You just want it to start sizzling and steaming off. And that steam will release like that little, that's where the cheese was sitting. Right there and right there and right there. Over here, don't look too bad. Little spot right there. That steam will release all that. And you can take your spatula and you can scrape it around again. Let the pan cool off. And then just wash it with a little soap and water. Rinse it really, really good. Maybe rinse it two or three times. Dry it. Put it back on the stove. Reseason it. But we'll go through the whole process. A little grease on the bottom there. Hopefully, let me wipe that grease up so that it doesn't get on the burner. Start smoking. And we'll let this pan come up to temp. We'll be back here in a little bit. All right, folks, we got some good heat in this pan. The handle, about 2 seconds. I can hold on to it for about two, maybe 3 seconds. We're going to turn the burner off. I'm going to turn my water on to hot. Let it get nice and hot. Pour a little water in here. We'll get some steam action. Scrape it with our wooden spatula. We'll dump that water out. We'll let it cool off. And then we'll scrub it out with some little bit of soap and water. Some people say you can't use soap. It'll kill your seasoning. But Dawn or basically any type of dish soap nowadays, I only trust Dawn. It's the best soap out there. If it's good enough to wash a baby duck, it's good enough to wash my cast iron. There's other brands too. Palmolive is decent. I just like the consistency of Dawn. It's thick, it's good suds, and it's biodegradable, and for me, it's the best. So that's what I use. I mean, you could use whatever you want. Just be careful of some of the generic soaps. They have some harsher chemicals in them, and their process is a little more crude when they create their product. And that's the reason why I trust Dawn instead of some generic cheap soap. Cheaper soaps will have some other harsher chemicals in it that I don't want in my cast iron. Check my water here. Yeah, I got steam coming off my sink. So I got good hot water. Put my little cover on, my handle cover. It was a little gift from me, from a good friend of mine. These things work pretty good. I used to use a rag, but these things are they're the best. You just, I grab it, slip it on right out of the oven, pull pan out of the oven, never burn my hand. And they work out pretty good. I like them. All right, we got good hot water here. Like I said, we're not going to put a lot of water in there. I just got a little orange juice glass full of water. And be careful when you do this. The steam coming up can burn you. Those orange juice glasses I have are also my shot glasses. Okay, we'll give this a little scrape. Like I said, the wood utensils is not going to ruin your seasoning. Just a little water sizzling in there is not going to ruin your seasoning. Just give this a little scrape. Get that water up on the sides a little bit. Oh, let's do a little splash. I'm going to have to do a little cleanup on the stove. Not bad. I think we're pretty good here. Got a little spot right there. Now you know you got a good seasoning on your pan when you can roll the water up on there on the edge. When you take the pan back, you see that water just rolls right off. It's got good seasoning in it. The only thing you don't want to cook in your pan is you don't want to cook tomatoes or tomato sauce in your pan. The acidic value of a tomato will etch your seasoning. It's not saying you can't cook a tomato sauce in a cast iron pot. It's just you're going to have to scrub it, and you're going to have to go through that long 3, 4, maybe even 5 times of re-seasoning in the oven, bake it in, cool it off, put it back on the stovetop, heat it up, re-season it. You're going to have to do that over and over and over because the acidity in tomatoes will take the seasoning out of your pan. A little barbecue sauce is not going to hurt. But I am going to re-season this one time. This pan is relatively new. It's got good seasoning on it, but it is relatively new. All right, I got my pan over here in the sink. I'm going to turn my water to warm, but not hot. Doesn't need to be hot. The pan, I'll let the pan cool down just a little bit. I can hold on to the handle for about 3-4 seconds. It's still a little warm. I'll take this warm water. You don't want to use cold water. Like I said, you can crack cast iron. So we're just going to give it a thorough rinse. There you go. It's cooled off nice. Now you know you got good seasoning. You roll the water off, and the water just sheens right off. Like that. Just like that. Just sheens right off. That's a good season. That's a good seasoning. In here you can see where it's stuck a little bit. The water is actually sticking to the pan. I don't know if you can see that. Like right there. The water is just beading. That's good seasoning right there. But right here, I kind of ruined the seasoning just a little bit. But the season is really not ruined. It just needs to be cleaned. It's got a little cheese. It's got a little meat particles and stuff. Got just a little dab of soap there. So Dawn, we're going to give it a little scrub. Give give it a good rinse. You can see the difference. See how that water is beading off? It's sticking a little bit right there. That's how you can tell. That water is just beading off. Needs to be scrubbed just a little bit, especially right in there. Flip it over, see if it'll come off. Yeah, right in there, a little bit. A little more scrubbing. Just a little bit. In those little areas. I hear Buddy outside barking. I don't know if you can hear that. Seems like I got a possum in my backyard. I thought Buddy was a bird dog, not a possum dog, but he's just letting that possum know to stay up in that tree. Don't come down. And see how we do now. I think that's pretty good. Yeah, I think that's pretty good. Take a towel. We'll dry this up. And we'll give it one quick little seasoning. Barbecue sauce is a little hard on cast iron. Like I said, this pan is relatively new. It had a good seasoning on it, but it's relatively new. But don't be afraid to cook things in your cast iron, thinking that it's going to ruin your seasoning. Even if it does ruin your seasoning, cast iron can be re-stripped, re-seasoned. All right, we'll put this back on the stove, and we'll do the seasoning process for just one seasoning. That's all it needs. When this pan has got a really, really good seasoning, after cleaning it, putting it back on the stove, heating it up, a little drop of oil, rub it around, take it off the burner, let it set, and it'd be done. Because I did the barbecue sauce and the cheese, had to scrub it a little hard. Got some pitting right there, but this is Lodge. Lodge is a little rough, but I like Lodge. But it takes a while for that seasoning to fill all them little cracks and not cracks, but little imperfections in the cast iron. Some people sand these. They'll use a sanding wheel, and they'll sand them down like almost a mirror polish. I don't like that. I prefer to have the rough surface, because after about a year, 2 years of cooking in this thing is going to be like glass. And I will be able to do tomatoes and anything in this, and it will just clean right up. But this pan is pretty good. It's clean. Like I said, we'll just do a one quick little seasoning process on the stovetop, get it up temp, little oil, little drop of oil, rub it around, put it in the oven, bake it at 350, 400 for about an hour, turn it off, let it cool off, be ready to go for the next time.